icy conditions, especially on bridges. That was the big problem yesterday for drivers. Today, 27 First News reporter Nadine Grimley learned what causes them to freeze so fast. She continues our coverage tonight.
We've all seen the signs driving, bridge ices before road. So what happened last night to cause this accident over the Meander Reservoir and a massive pileup on 711?
It's a perfect storm of things that happened.
Brent Kovacs with ODOT says crews were last out salting 711 at around 1:30 yesterday afternoon.
The weather trends were looking like it was drying up, so we weren't out there at the time that the crash did happen.
But when the sun set and the winds were blowing, you had the perfect storm for icy bridges.
That's Tom Klaka, Assistant Highway Superintendent for the Trumbull County Engineer's Office. He explains why bridges freeze over so fast.
Because there's nothing under the bridge to keep it insulated. The ground keeps the roadways somewhat insulated. When you have the wind conditions that we had yesterday with the wind chill factor blowing under the bridge as well as over top, it'll create the icy condition.
Let's face it, we can all be a little bit more careful behind the wheel, especially on nights like last night when there is a possibility that there may be black ice on the roads. Now, experts tell me the best advice they can give anyone who is driving is that if they're approaching a bridge, to slow down before you hit it and to maintain your speed throughout the entire length of the bridge. Because when you accelerate and you brake, that's when you start to lose control of your vehicle.
We're in winter, and you have to adjust your driving time, leave a little bit early, give yourself some extra time, and drive according to the conditions. Just because the roads may be dry and clear doesn't mean the bridges are.
On the roads of the valley, Nadine Grimley, WKBN 27 First News.